Okay.
So internal rotation with 90-90 position, my torso is gonna actually turn towards the back leg. That back leg is the leg we're focusing on for internal rotation. I'll make sure I'm in 90-90 position. And then before I even begin anything, I'm gonna ensure that I can start to do internal and external rotation with just my hips. So I'm really pulsing up through my handlebars, my hands, and I'm focusing on getting the hip to internally rotate and externally rotate. Internal, external, internal, external, internal, external. Once I get that down for about a minute of doing that, I'll then internally rotate, externally rotate. So now I'm going to start to do a pales contraction of external rotation, bringing my foot into the ground as much as I possibly can. I'm forcing everything into there right now. I'm loading up to my safest yet greatest effort. And once I get to that max of where I'm focusing, I'll then shift that energy and tension to my knee while shifting the hip internally. Now I'm actually gonna evert the ankle so I can shift everything, focusing on that knee, pulling down. And I'm bringing my torso further in as I bring that hip in and squeeze into my knee. And then as I do that, I'm gonna sink my hip down, keeping it internally rotated, sink my butt down further as I push myself into the stretch. And then I'll come out of it, and you can oscillate and then switch legs. Also on top of that, a passive range liftoff will end up being in this position here, still focusing on internal rotation. Shift the hip forward, lock it there, and see if you can lift the foot off the floor without extending my spine. So only the femur is moving, I'm pushing through the